Hi, I'm Peter Clift, Professor of Geosciences at Louisiana State University. In earlier videos, we explored how the growth of mountains in Asia and changes in global climate have affected the summer rainfall. We also saw how the rainfall has controlled the rivers that supply sediment and water to the densely inhabited floodplains and deltas of the region. Now we're going to see how changes in the monsoon affected ancient people, as well as exploring how future climate change may impact modern society. So how does the monsoon affect early societies, their rise and collapse? Everyone needs to eat, and a functioning society requires a reliable supply of food. Crops like rice, corn, and wheat are especially important. These and other crops depend on good growing conditions, sunlight, water, and nutrient-rich soil. We know that the climate across Asia has become progressively colder and drier over the last 8,000 years, but the cooling has not been steady or gentle. These changes have affected the many cultures and civilizations of India, Southeast Asia, and China. The earliest civilizations of this region developed in the Indus Valley, in what is now India and Pakistan, as well as in the Yellow River Valley in northern China. Both of these areas experienced a sharp drop in population when cities were abandoned around 4,000 years ago. Climate records show that this was a time when the monsoon rains diminished, and archaeologists think that the drying climate was an important factor that led these people to scatter into the countryside as farms failed to feed them. Climate evolution has been reconstructed from studying both stalagmites in caves and lake sediments, because these are linked to the supply of water. These records from southern China reveal that many imperial Chinese dynasties ended at times when summer monsoon rains were weak. Drought would have caused crop failures, food shortages, and high prices. Skyrocketing prices would have put pressure on the government, especially because the emperor himself guaranteed the rains and the success of the harvests. A weaker, poorer government would also have been more vulnerable to invasion and civil unrest at home. The armies of Genghis Khan are famous for conquering all of Eurasia, from Hungary to Korea, during the 13th century, forming the largest land empire in history. The Mongols were able to sweep all before them because of their amazing cavalry, but horses need to eat grass. New climate reconstructions, that based on tree rings, these grow faster when the climate is wetter, show that the Mongol invasion occurred during one of the wettest episodes in Asia over the last 1,000 years. Later, as the climate dried, the grasslands contracted and the Mongol Empire broke up, no longer able to easily communicate across the vast distances. The Khmer Empire ruled much of Southeast Asia around their heartlands in modern Cambodia from the 9th to the 15th centuries. The fabulous temple and city at Angkor Wat was built in the 12th century by the Khmers, but later abandoned in the early 15th century. The city subsisted on water supplied from Tonle Sap Lake, which is filled by monsoonal flooding from the Mekong River. Tree ring records from this area show that the city was abandoned following several decades of drought. Without the overflowing summer water from the Mekong, the large population of the city was unable to continue in this location. So what about future climate change? We know that droughts continued to cause famine and societal unrest until the latter part of the 20th century, when the construction of dams allowed better water control. Even so, such modern methods still have their limits, as shown by the catastrophic flooding in 2010 across Pakistan, when the Indus River burst its banks and caused billions of dollars of damage and loss of life. It is uncertain how well we will be able to respond to changing monsoon strength in the future. A warming world mostly means stronger summer rains, but these will be in the form of more destructive storms rather than the gentle rain favoured by farmers. Furthermore, higher temperatures cause more evaporation and potentially drier soils. Areas of Pakistan, India, and especially northern China are particularly projected to experience significant drying over the 21st century, while rising sea levels may inundate rich agricultural land along the coasts. While some of these changes may be mitigated, this will take forward planning, as well as better modelling of how the monsoon is affected by other factors, such as pollution. I hope you enjoyed learning about the monsoon and seeing how it affects and is influenced by the people, the geology, and the climate around Asia. You can also check out these references to learn more, especially this newly released book that discusses in detail how the climate and human societies have changed across Asia over thousands of years. And be sure to watch the three other videos we have made that talk about different aspects of the monsoon.